Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to create run-in headings in Microsoft Word. Specifically, we'll create run-in headings that will appear correctly in the table of contents. First, we'll use Word's default styles to create run-in headings that are aligned with the left margin. Then we'll customize a default style to create indented run-in headings, such as those needed for the fourth and fifth heading levels in APA style. Today I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to the single purchase versions of the software back to Word 2013. These steps don't apply to Word for Mac or Word for the web. Before we start, please note that this first basic method, which will align the run-in headings with the left margin, assumes that your default heading styles have not been customized. To begin, select the Home tab. Although not required, I recommend selecting the Show Hide button to show your formatting marks. Next, type the heading text on its own line above the text it represents, and then select it, and select the heading level you want to use in the Styles group. It's important to note that Word includes 9 heading levels. However, only a few will appear in your Styles group when you open a new document. Additional heading levels will appear after you use higher level headings. For example, Heading 4 will appear after you use Heading 3. Now place your cursor at the very end of the heading and type Ctrl, Alt, Enter to create a style separator, which is a hidden formatting mark that allows you to have more than one style in the same paragraph. The paragraph below should now move in line with your new run-in heading. If you selected the Show Hide button earlier, you can now reselect it to re-hide your formatting marks. When you create or update your table of contents later on, the run-in heading should appear correctly with the other headings. To create an indented run-in heading, we first need to customize one of the default heading styles. To do so, select the Home tab, and then right-click the heading level in the Styles group, and select Modify from the shortcut menu. When the Modify Style dialog box appears, select the Format button, followed by Paragraph from the drop-down menu. Next, select First Line in the Special menu, and then enter the length of the indent in the By text box. I'm going to leave mine at 1/2 inch. You can also adjust the line spacing and the space before and after to match your paragraph style. You may also want to select Don't Add a Space between paragraphs of the same style to prevent extra spaces in the body of the text. When you're finished, select the OK button. Make any additional formatting changes in the Modify Style dialog box, such as font, size, underlining, boldness, or italics, and color. Next, ensure that only in this document is selected if you want to limit your customized style to your current document. Also ensure that Automatically Update is not selected. If Automatically Update is selected, you won't be able to edit the styles of individual same-level headings. Finally, select the OK button. Now, once again, type the heading text on its own line above the text it represents, and then select it, and select the heading level you just customized in the Styles group. Place your cursor at the end of the heading, and then type Ctrl, Alt, Enter to create a style separator. The paragraph below the heading should now appear in line with the indented heading. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. For more information about working with headings, please see my playlist, How to Use Headings in Microsoft Word. And for even more Word tutorials, please see my other playlist, How to Use Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below, along with my website, erinwrightwriting.com, which shows all the steps we just performed with images. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.